Welcome to the 2020 National Keystone Conference and the first ever virtual conference. I'm Fatima, and this year's theme is We the Youth Declare. We will be heard, seen, and united. I'm coming to you from my club, the Lee Wetherington Boys and Girls Club in sunny Sarasota, Florida. Can my Florida and Southeast clubs show me some love in the chat box? Like you, I am disappointed not to see everyone in person and explore the national monuments in Washington, D.C. Still, I am so excited to be your host, and we had to stay close to home because of the pandemic. But hey, we can still be heard, seen, and united. I want to encourage everyone watching today to stay tuned in the whole conference during our time together. You'll have a chance to answer some questions and win some awesome prizes. Now more than ever, we need to be heard, seen, and united for change. The pain we are feeling as a nation, as Keystoners, and as individuals is real. The deaths of George Floyd, Ahmaud Arbery, Breonna Taylor, Rashad Brooks, and too many other Black Americans has left us hurt and outraged. We've had the opportunity to reflect on what equality and justice really mean and how far we still need to go. Youth voice, mobilization, and leadership are central to driving positive, meaningful change. That sounds like us, doesn't it, Keystoners? So I hope you stay tuned till the end, because we are going to share ways you can take action through a little TLC, thinking, learning, and creating change. I encourage you to lean on those around you for support and encouragement. Reach out to your advisors, as they are willing and ready to help you. I know mine is, and with that, I want to introduce my awesome advisor, Jeffrey.
Thank you, Fatima. Welcome, Keystoners. We are so happy to be hosting this virtual Keystone Conference from the Boys and Girls School of Sarasota County. I'd like to introduce the members of this year's steering committee and their advisors. I have enjoyed working with this impressive group on this year's conference. And for those tuning in, be sure to show this group some love in the chat box. They have worked incredibly hard to make this virtual conference a reality. Let's get started with some introductions. Of course, you already know me and Fatima. Next, we have Haley and Jeff from the Boys and Girls Club of Richfield. Next, Taylor and Matrice are from Joint Base Andrews Youth Center. Marina and Brittany are from the Minot Youth Activity Center. From the Boys and Girls Club of Benton County, we have Shakira and Ashley. Next up are Darius and Monica from the Boys and Girls Club of Collin County. Then there's Montez and Linda from the Boys and Girls Club of Greater Washington. Marlon and Maria are from Kings Bay Submarine Base. Next up are Daniela and Christina from Boys and Girls Club of West Valley. And last, but certainly not least, we have Jamarlin and Alexander from the Boys and Girls Clubs of the Los Angeles Harbor. Now let's roll the video.
We've been planning for the 2020 Keystone Conference for how long now?
Since December 2019. Yeah, since December 2019.
I still can't believe I was selected to be part of the National Keystone Conference Steering Committee.
Why not? You had what it takes. And you better get ready. It's only a few months away.
I'm so excited to be going to D.C. It'll be my first time there.
And get this, when we land at DCA, we might even be able to see the MLK Memorial.
So, the Keystone Conference will be here soon. I'm keeping hope alive that Beyonce or Rihanna will make her appearance.
So, I need to tell you something.
I just don't know what to say.
She's a little upset. Maybe more than a little.
How does Corona just come in when nobody invited it?
I don't think it works that way.
Keystone.
Keystone. I was really looking forward to going to DC.
So, I just got an email from the National Keystone Advisors.
Please tell me it's good news. Is Keystone really back on?
So, we're back on. We're going virtual.
It's gonna be different, but let's get it. Keystone! Keystone! Keystone!
I hope a big celebrity joins. What you think?
I don't know. Maybe. Let's tune in now and see.
Thanks, everyone. You are some of the most inspiring teens I know. I am honored to introduce our next guest. Keystoners, please welcome the president and CEO of Boys and Girls Clubs of America, Mr. Jim Clark.
Hello, everyone, and thank you so much for joining us virtually for the 53rd annual National Keystone Conference. The conference, of course, was supposed to take place in Washington, D.C., and I know how hard all of you worked to earn money to make that exciting trip. COVID-19, of course, made such an event impossible. But it has to be disappointing not to visit the nation's capital with thousands of your peers. The good news? You hold the power, individually and collectively, to enact change. The theme for this year's Keystone Conference is clear and direct. We the youth declare to be heard, seen, and united, just like the shirt I'm wearing. As you participate in this afternoon's programming, I urge you to do just that. Ask questions, share your thoughts and opinions. We want and need to hear your voice because we believe teens have the power to make a difference in your life, your club, and your community. And then later this afternoon, we will present a call to action to help you help others right now. Please stay safe, wear your face mask, wash your hands, and maintain social distance, and be patient. These are tough times, but you're tougher and you will prevail. Thank you and have a great conference.
Thank you so much, Mr. Clark. We really appreciate everything you do for us. Did you know Mr. Clark is from Wisconsin? Let's hear it from those of you in the Midwest in the chat box. I also want to thank all of the advisors, club staff, and national staff who have helped with this year's conference. On behalf of all of us, I want to send a special thank you to our presenting sponsor, Aaron's, and our session sponsors, T-Mobile and Dove. With Aaron's support of the National Keystone Conference and Teen Center Refreshes all across the country, Aaron's has been a critical partner since 2015, committed to helping teens build confidence and leadership skills to set them up for future success. At this time, we would like to share a special welcome message from Aaron's.
Hey, Keystoners, I'm Stephanie Kozel with Aaron's, and we are thrilled to be sponsoring the National Keystone Conference for the sixth year in a row. While this is obviously very different from previous conferences we've been a part of, we remain grateful that even in this unique time, we are able to come together to celebrate your incredible achievements. The theme of this year's conference is Heard, Seen, and United. And all of us at Aaron's are proud to support you as you grow as leaders, using your voices to bring our communities together and help us chart a positive path forward. In the last 5 years, with your help, we've completed 42 teen center refreshes for Keystone clubs across the country. While a few of our spring 2020 makeovers have been delayed due to circumstances beyond our control, we hope to be back up and running this fall to complete those and to move forward with our next group of refreshes. We are anxiously looking for deserving Keystone clubs to refresh as soon as it's safe for us all to be back together in person. Despite the pause I mentioned, we were able to bring a little Aaron's magic to several clubs last school year in places like West Palm Beach, Florida, Plano, Texas, Boston, Massachusetts, Fayetteville, Arkansas, and Diverville, Mississippi. When we meet you at our Teen Center refreshes, we are blown away by your enthusiasm, excitement, and all that you, as Keystoners, do to promote engagement in your community. We know these refreshes are important because they help make Keystone clubs destinations where you want to spend your time, creating a safe place for you to meet as leaders, to study, to hang out, to plan community service activities, and to prepare for your college careers and the next steps in your lives. We take tremendous pride in playing even a small part in helping you grow on your paths toward success. It's truly inspiring, and it's the primary reason we do what we do. So, on behalf of Aaron's and our more than 11,000 employees across the country, thank you again for the amazing work you are doing in your communities, and keep it up. Enjoy today's program and have fun.
Thanks again to Aaron's. I am excited about presenting the first three awards of this year's conference. Be sure to congratulate all the nominees in this chat. Now, let's start with academic success. This year's nominees are USAG Vicenza Italy Teen Center Keystone Cougars, Ridgefield Boys and Girls Club Ridgefield Tigers, Rogers Teen Center of the Boys and Girls Clubs of Benton County Unidos Keystone. And their award for academic success goes to USAG Vicenza Italy Teen Center Keystone Cougars. Congratulations, Keystone Cougars. Can I hear from our overseas military Keystoners in the chat? Next up is the award for career preparation. The nominees are Moody Air Force Base Youth Program, Moody Major Keys, Ramstein Youth Programs High Key Keystone, Harley and Ruth Barker Branch of Boys and Girls Clubs of Greater Scottsdale, Barker ECC Keystone. And the award for career preparation goes to Moody Air Force Base Youth Programs Major Keys. Congrats, Major Keys. Next up, the award for community service. The nominees are Boys and Girls Clubs of Northern Rhode Island, Woonsocket Novens, USAG Rhineland Falls, Baumholder Rock Keystone Club, Ridgefield Boys and Girls Club, Ridgefield Tigers. And the award for community service goes to Boys and Girls Clubs of Northern Rhode Island, Woonsocket Novens. Congrats, Woonsocket. Next up, we have some entertainment from Boys and Girls Clubs of Garden Grove. Caitlin and Madeline performing the Descendants Dance Medley.
From the north to the south, from the east to the west, lost boys, lost girls, you all know you're the best. Hit the streets, it's your day, turn it up, now's your chance. It's time to get up on your feet and dance.
I wanna see you all rep your block, I wanna see you all rep your block. Show you pride, let me hear you shout. We're from the Isle of the Lost. If you're down, then make you move, but you best not hesitate. Come on. Today's the day that you won't forget. The best to come may happen yet. Take a bow, it won't be your last. You're from the Isle of anybody at. It's good to be bad, and we're proof of that. Used to be lost, now we're on the map. Used to steal specs, now we're giving back. Remember that.
Yeah.
Wow, thanks so much for sharing your talents, Caitlin and Madeline. I am always amazed by the many skills of club members, and those girls can dance. Now, we're going to get a little more serious. 2020 has been a hard year, but also a hopeful one. Across the country and around the world, we have seen how young people can make a difference. We are the next generation, and our voices are our power. Our next speaker is going to talk about how we can amplify our voices. Pay close attention, because afterward, we're going to be playing a game we're calling What's the Word? We'll ask about certain keywords that the speaker says. If you get the right answer, you will have a chance to win an awesome prize. Our next speaker is a poet, performer, and screenwriter from Brooklyn, New York. He is the author of poetry collection Straight Razor. His memoir, County of Kings, was adapted for the stage and produced by Spike Lee. He was the subject of a documentary called Lemon. He has appeared in movies like The Soloist and Spike Lee's She Hate Me, Inside Man, and Sucker Free City. In his TED Talk, Please Don't Take My Air Jordans, he spoke about his influences as a poet and performed the title poem by Reg E. Gaines. Please welcome Lemon Anderson.
Greetings, Keystone members. Salutations to all the young leaders, all of the mentors, facilitators, organizers helping us here in cyberspace. All of you have been working so tirelessly to make this digital gathering of our tribes run for the ages. My name is Lemon Anderson. I'm a working artist, poet, performer, screenwriter, but most importantly, I'm a mentor, an educator. Today, I'm coming to you from a sunny day in Brooklyn, USA. I'm hoping to leave you with a few strong words to live by. But before I signify with you all, I just really want to thank all of the Keystone staff, Lisa Sunart and the executive staff and the board members for bringing me back. Really appreciate you. Word has it I was highly requested, and for that, I'm thankful. And the tank of my gratitude is sincerely full. So about 5 years ago, I had my first experience with the Keystone Conference, and I have to say I was beyond blown away by the young leaders and the talent in the room. I had no idea what I was in for, and whatever my expectations were, you guys surpassed them. But what I was even more impressed with was the effort of all the mentors and the leaders and the facilitators who helped bring the youth forward, to help guide them. I too am a product of overwhelming support from my community. I too have been blessed with the kindness and patience and generosity of folks outside of my immediate family who cared so much about my progress as a young man, and I became so successful because of them. So I wanted to thank you guys, you, the leaders, the adults in the room, sincerely. You already know the African proverb that it takes a village to raise a child, but seriously, what I witnessed 5 years ago at the Keystone Conference in Orlando felt more like an undivided nation, something to look forward to. So let's get to it. As you can see from the sign of the times, we are all bearing witness to a great change happening in the world. And great change, as we know, can only be condensed to the power of one word, one mighty word, a responsible word. And that word is revolution. It's what built this nation. Now, a revolution can be led by peace. It can be led by love. It can be led by protests, rally cries, bended knees, and picket signs. A revolution can be led by fire and song and music and style and science and the arts. But the most powerful revolution of all can only be led by the North Star of our young people. If you look back at the history of this complex nation and the world, you will see it was the youth who led the way. It was you who strived to make change happen by any means necessary. For the only voices that remained permanent were coming out of the mouths and actions on the front lines of our young rebels, rebelling against injustice. Not the preacher on the soapbox, not the teacher in the classroom, not the politicians, nor the union leaders, not the statesmen, but the bold, brave boys and girls, young LGBTQs who had their fist in the air fighting for the power of the people. It was only through the movement and action of our youth that we have seen real change happen in this country, a change that could spin this planet on its axis, shift the paradigm, make freedom the new wave. So I'm asking you great, brave, bold young warriors to remain tireless in this pursuit, even when the times of quarantine and solitude make Monday mornings feel like Friday nights without the lights. Even when the fires you have inside your chest feels like you're only holding a candle in the sun, keep lighting the way. Be the beacon on top of these hills with your phones on and your history on high def. Keep filming what so many of us don't want to see. Keep marching with signs held high above the crowds. Keep questioning those who are sworn to protect us. Keep stepping out of your fears and into the shoes of your faith. You will outlive us with your demands. You will be the best generation the universe has ever witnessed, and the stars will applaud you. Keep reminding this systemic problem that has put glass ceilings above your ancestors' heads that they will be shattered by your voices, by the echoes of her name, and keep saying her name, Breonna Taylor, Breonna Taylor. Taylor, Breonna Taylor, keep stepping into these digital square spaces with your round ideas, with your revolution. You are the ultimate change maker. Tear down the popularity contests that plague and bully your peers. Keep making friendly requests to your friends, not to be followers on social media, but to be leaders in the real world. Be the fearless ones during this endless documentary we're living in called The Matrix, and finally get us to the credits. Keep organizing like you do so well, Keystoners. Keep gathering around the campfire of your imaginations, crooning new freedom songs. Keep coming together in these beautiful ciphers I've witnessed over the years, watching you root for each other's dreams, staying woke even while the rest of us sleepwalk through our conformities. It's never too late, but now is the time. Now is your time to show up to the ballot boxes by the millions, like you show up to your dances, tick-tock your way to the polls, take granny with you. Now is your time to take back the world by storm, rain on the liberties these old politicians and economists are taking advantage of. Cut them off at the banks with your rail grinds and your kickflips. Keep sewing yourself into the fabric of this new wave, your fashions, your statements, your poetic prose, your paintings, your photo ops and your op-eds. Document the times we live in with your wild scripts. Keep allowing us to see ourselves through the colored lens of your cameras. Make your truth the new pop culture, justice the new trend. Lead our young sneakerheads into a world where the only souls they should care about are the ones with the black souls in them. Help us cut the overflow of black and brown bodies drowning in the poverty of the prison pipelines. Help them find air on the other side of the street. And for the young Keystoners on the other side who feel like they don't have a voice because of the skin they're living in, those who are white, Asian, mixed, who have been stagnant these last few weeks, overwhelmed with the crisis of their identities, your black and brown brothers and sisters will uplift you. Please know that we are all part of the same garden. Some of the most beautiful flowers blossom in the fall and bear the winters. There are many colors to a rose. Put your pride to the side of your hip and find a fellow shoulder to lean on. Don't be afraid to ask questions you don't know the answer to. All young leaders, ride your waves into the promised land. If the songs you hear on the radio aren't empowering our young women, change that tune. Don't dig holes in the souls of our indigenous people. Support the united language of our divided tongues. Tear down liberty when the bells don't ring for us. Unmask her, balance her scales, for only the youth can bring us to the promised land. And we will be here standing in the shadows of your revolution, ready to follow your lead. Welcome to this year's Keystone Conference. Keep on.
Thank you, Lemon Anderson. I really appreciate you sharing with us, and I know my fellow Keystoners do too. Can my Keystoners give some major props in the chat to Lemon? Okay, so get your phones out or open up your email in front of your computer. It's time to win some prizes. What's the word? It's pretty simple. You literally just have to email the correct answer to the following question to keystoneclubs@bgca.org, and you will be entered to win a prize. I'm going to read the question and you are going to send in the correct answer via email. I hope you are paying attention. Okay, here we go. Lemon mentioned being great, noble, brave, and blank, young warriors. Select the following multiple choice options. A, courageous, B, bold, C, woke, or D, loud. Lemon mentioned being great, noble, brave, and blank, young warriors. Select the following multiple choice options. A, courageous, B, bold, C, woke, or D, loud. So it's kind of weird talking to you all without being able to see you. So now, we're gonna take a minute to show your vibe and taking some selfies and sharing them. Okay, take out your phone and take two photos of how you wanna be seen. Here are mine. Be sure to take the selfie vertical. Now, it's your turn to show your vibe. And of course, don't forget to add your selfie to your Instagram story by using the conference hashtag WeTheYouth2020 and tag BGCA_clubs on Instagram. Let's celebrate with a quick Keystone clap. If it's your first conference, it goes like this. Keystone, let's do it again.
Keystone. 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 Keystone.
Next, we're going to be talking about emotional wellness. It's always an important issue for teens, but especially this year. How do we focus on mental health when it seems like our whole world has changed? Our next speaker is going to be talking about this important topic. Pay attention, because there will be a chance for more prizes after this session, and you don't want to miss out on your chance to win. My fellow steering committee member and friend, Marlon, is going to be interviewing the amazingly talented and fabulous Damaris Lewis. Damaris is an actress, model, dancer, philanthropist, and entrepreneur. More than that, she is a Boys and Girls Club alumni and currently serves as an official ambassador for the wellness for BGCA. She is on a mission to illuminate the world with positivity, and I can't wait to tune into this interview.
Welcome everyone to our super session topic on emotional wellness. This topic has been at the top of our minds lately because it's a difficult time right now. With the killings of Ahmaud Arbery, Breonna Taylor, and George Floyd, on top of the stress we are all feeling from the COVID-19 pandemic, many of us have felt anxiety, anger, sadness, or other emotions. And we have had missed out on a lot of milestones, such as prom and graduation. Damaris, I am so excited to have you joining us today as a club alum and BGCA's Ambassador of Wellness. I can't wait to hear from you on this topic of emotional wellness. Thank you so much for joining us today, Damaris. We are here to discuss and address a lot of emotions many have felt over the past few months or longer. So let's get started. First question, how are you, and can you tell us a little bit about yourself?
First of all, thank you, Marlon, for that awesome introduction, and congratulations on your graduation. I'm well. Thank you for asking. I am here. I am present. I am healthy. I am all the things that one could ask for during a time like this. And I'm excited to share what's in my brain, so.
I did a little research before our little interview here, and I noticed that you were a supermodel, is that right?
So yeah, a little bit about me. First and foremost, I am a Boys and Girls Club kid. So I grew up going to the Kerry Gardens Clubhouse, Madison Square, that no longer exists out in Coney Island. But yes, I have been modeling for the past 15 years. It has been a highlight of my life. I've done things from Sports Illustrated Swimsuit Edition to shooting for Yves Saint Laurent and other really great brands, as well as transitioning into a host. I worked on NBA TV and TNT as an NBA style correspondent. And I also am a professional dancer, and I toured with the late great Prince Rogers Nelson on his tours up until he passed away. And in the past couple of years, I have been fully acting, and I appeared in Black Klansman, as well as currently starring as Blackfire on the Titans show on DC Universe, as well as a show called C on Apple TV. And I feel like we're just on my Wikipedia. And I have a movie coming out starring myself, Michael Ealy, and Hilary Swank later this year. So that's kind of about me. You know, that's what I've been up to. That's what I've been up to on the surface level, but a lot has been going on up here.
Oh, that sounds very interesting. And to be honest, I'm a little bit jealous that you get to work with all those famous people. and I'm sure you've experienced a lot of things like in that area. And my first question on this topic would be, what experiences have you had the most, or like what experiences had the most impact on your decision to be an emotional wellness advocate?
Wow. What experiences got me to this point? First and foremost, as a kid growing up in Brooklyn. Going to the Boys and Girls Club was the first time that I saw what happens when other people show up for you every day. So when I didn't know how to do a homework problem and there was a counselor there who could help me, or in the summertime, when my mom had to go to work and I had a place to be every day, the Boys and Girls Club gave me that love that I think so many of us long for. Overall, in the past few years, I was able to completely transform my life by transforming my thinking. I was able to transform my life by transforming how I ate. And I just realized that that's really what we're all looking for. We're looking to feel good. And the question here is, how do you do that? So once I knew it was very complex, but on the grassroots level, a very simple thing, I've made it my mission to make sure that everybody understands that everything that they're looking for is up here.
All that sounds, it sounds pretty like close to home. I know for me, the Boys and Girls Club is pretty much like, it's always been around. It's always been something that I had. It helped me cope with like different challenges and stuff like that, that I had going on in my life. And for like the present, how have you been coping with the current challenges that are like on the phones and the TVs and social channels?
So right now, I've just been reminded of the quote that thoughts are things. And also, I don't know if you're familiar with it, but the algorithm. So when you log on to your, are you familiar with the algorithm?
No, ma'am. If you could explain a little bit, that'd be great.
When you follow someone on Instagram, when you look up something on the internet, the computer creates an algorithm that's specific for you. So when you log on to Instagram and you see all of these posts, right, they're already pre-picked for you. So sometimes you log on and it might seem, you know, like the sky is falling, but it's because that's by design, right? So if I was to only follow pages that were about travel, I would only see travel things when I logged onto my social media. If I was to only follow the news, I would only see the news. So what happens when all of us, everybody who's watching this right now, has a different algorithm when they log onto their phone? Depending on what you see, your brain is going to react to it a different way. So if you see something that feels threatening, your brain will take that as a threat. It's called the fight or flight response. So during this time, what I've been doing is I've been filtering what I listen to, what I watch, my time outside, and really just making it a priority to shut off my devices whenever things do feel overwhelming, especially, you know, being inside, you can only help but so much. So staying informed, but also staying informed from a place of, okay, how can I help? Because self-care is also a form of activism. You can't show up for others unless you show up for yourself first. So during this time, it's been my priority to make sure that my brain is in a place to show up for everyone else. And that's also what I want to remind everybody who's watching this, that your greatest work is you. So in a time where it might feel like the sky is falling, it's important to sit back and ask yourself, what can I do for me first? And then go out and change the world.
Oh, thank you so much for explaining and teaching me exactly what the algorithm is. My second question, well, actually my third question, would be, why do you think there's such a high percentage of teens currently dealing with mental health struggles?
Currently amongst teens, I truly believe that on a grand scale, you're not taught what to do with everyone else's information. So before, you know, the digital world, when you woke up in the morning, you ask yourself, what do I want today? And you have breakfast and then you go to school. But now you wake up, you look at your phone, And within 5 minutes, you've scrolled and you've gone, oh my gosh, I forgot her birthday. Oh my gosh, I can't believe that that bad thing happened. Oh my gosh, it's going to rain tomorrow. Oh my gosh, the Cheetos, they have these ingredients in them. Like, it's been 5 minutes, you haven't gotten out of bed, and now you're terrified that the Cheetos are going to come, you know, for you, whatever that thing is, right? So I do think on a grand scale, kids just aren't taught, not kids, but teens and younger generations, my generation, older generations, we're not taught how to handle this much information being pumped to us at once, right? So you have something in your body called your adrenals. And your adrenal glands are responsible for that fight or flight response I was talking about, right? So when you get scared of something, your body tightens up, right? Imagine being like this all day. All day, right? So that's, I think, what's happening to a lot of our youth. I think that they are getting a lot of information in that they want to help with that they might not be able to. So then they're also spending the time going, I can't help. When the reality is, most of us don't think about these things when we're outside at the park or, you know, when we're on vacation. So as a whole, I do believe that you are the answer. You are all going to be the ones that change the world. But at the current time, you guys are getting a really heavy dose of information, past, present, and potentially future. And that's a lot to carry on your shoulders. So I thank you for being the ones that I know are going to change the world, but I also give you a hug because that's a really hard task at hand. And you need each other to figure out how to do that.
Yeah, I totally agree with you that like we all need each other. And for me, I'm part of a military family. So like we have this thing like on at our club called Military Teen Ambassador. I'm not sure if you've heard of that or not. You probably have. And like we have this thing called the 7 C's that we teach to other military teens. And one of the C's is coping. Mm-hmm. And that basically like it has us like teach of like coping strategies and like how to deal with like such as like friends moving away, like other military friends, or you moving away or having to deal with like your parent gone. And then you have to like figure out how to like incorporate everything until they get back. And with that said, I was trying to see if you had any tips on what we can do as teens to stay mentally, emotionally, and physically healthy.
Absolutely. First of all, you inspire me. Just want to put that out there. Thanks for showing up. And first thing we're going to do is we're going to take a deep breath in. Ready? Let's take a deep breath in. Okay. And let it out. Right? That's the first thing that we're all going to do, right? So I would say a bit of homework. The best thing that you can do during this time is reconnect with stillness. What happens when you are constantly taking in information, I don't know if you realize it, but maybe sometimes your eyes get dry or your neck hurts because you've been in this position all day, right? Our bodies weren't designed for us to be here, right? It looks funny because it is funny. Our bodies weren't designed for us to not breathe fully. So the first thing that you could do when you feel overwhelmed is to stop, just close your eyes, take a deep breath in, and let it out, because that allows oxygen to fill your body and it actually calms your brain down when you do that. In another level of that, we call it meditation. So my favorite thing to do personally is to think about my favorite place in the world, right? Close my eyes, put on some music that's soothing, and just sit there. Just sit there for an hour and don't do anything. Don't text, don't read, don't do it. You're looking at me like that sounds like a task.
I don't think I could sit there for an hour and just not do anything. I feel like that'd be challenging for me.
And it's one of the best challenges I would say that you could probably take for yourself right now, because your body just is not designed to always be on. You know that time when you're like thinking about an answer to a question and you have to think about it, you have to get silent in order for it to come to you. Sometimes right. You're like X plus 2X plus 9 plus, and then you stop and you go, It's because you stopped. It's because you took a break. It's because you reconnected with that breath. So that's gonna be my first thing. My second recommendation is gonna be to really focus on who you follow on social media. Focus on people who make you feel good. Focus on pages that make you feel good. If you love classical music, find some classical music to listen to. Find some classical artists to follow. Design your life the way that you want it. Because when you start to design your life the way that you want it, then it starts to become the life that you dreamed of. And that's the easiest way to navigate through this time. Another thing would be through nutrition. Heavy sugars and caffeines and a lot of the foods that we in our communities have been proven to actually keep us anxious. And especially with a pandemic, I'm gonna throw a little statistic at you. 70% of your immune system lives in your gut. 70% of your immune system lives in your gut, right?
I did not know that.
Here you go. So you have a virus that is out. Nobody can see it. Nobody knows about it. But your immune system has evolved to be able to fight things off. If your immune system is spending all of its time fighting off bad foods that it doesn't like, it's not going to have the time to fight off a virus. So what you want to do right now, it's not a full food overhaul, but you want to start adding in some leafy greens if you can, some tea or some thyme or just more water. You can start there, just drinking more water. You're looking at me like, yeah, that's just not a...
Yeah, I had like 4 bottles of water today before this in preparation.
Here we are. So, you know, it's going to improve your skin. It's going to improve your hair. It's going to improve your mind. And so really just kind of, it's not one thing. Wellness is not one thing. And what works for me might not work for you. That's the most important part of it. Everybody who's watching this right now has to find their own formula. The goal is feeling good. And truly feeling good in a place where your body thanks you for it. So you're gonna start with, you know, quiet time. You're going to ask yourself, like, are these people who I follow on the internet really helping me? And we're gonna look at the foods that we're eating and figure out if we can switch that up a little bit, add a little bit more water. You know, you gotta make wellness fun, because if not, it's a chore. Nobody really likes chores.
Yeah. I just want to say thank you very much for that, for all those suggestions. And something that like hits close to me would be, sorry to take a little dive here, but
no, sorry. Like,
the teen suicide rate around here has been something that I've seen increase in the past couple of years, because I've lost four or three friends and more that have committed. Are not committed, but like attempted. So it's been something that I've been dealing with. And I guess one of my questions would be, personally for me, would be, what can teens do safely now to help other teens and wider in the community to support their emotional health?
Brilliant question. And I send so much, love to you, because I know that that's not an easy thing to deal with. Two things. I want you to know that the common denominator in everything you said goes right back to the mind, right? And so I think, unfortunately, we've been trained to silence is good for the self, but it's not always great for the people around us, right? This is a great time to ask your friends, how are you doing? How's your mind? How's your brain? Have you gone outside? Are you drinking your water? Accountability, right? Check-ins with the people that you love. There's a quote that says, check on your strong friends. There's going to be a lot of people right now, especially who aren't going to show weakness because they have to be strong for their parents and, you know, they're essential workers. But that doesn't always help them in the long run. So get some groups together of people who listen to music together. You know, it's more about togetherness. It's more about community, but also like creating a space where people know it's okay that they can reach out to you. And it's from a place of love and it's from a place of care. I know for me personally that it's always helped when you have somebody to talk to, whether that's therapy or just a friend who is not judgmental, but truly, truly, truly letting people know how you feel without fearing the consequences from it. Even if the answer is not what you wanted to hear, even if you confide in someone and they don't care about what you say, you should still be proud that you took the time to better yourself. So really just being you as you are and curious and open and caring, that's what we need more of, togetherness.
Oh, thank you so much. And I really appreciate the advice and just the time you've taken out of your day to talk to us and letting us know that we're all important and that we all matter. Do you have any final remarks for the teens who are going to be tuned in?
You're welcome. I would not want to spend my day doing anything else, I promise. My final remarks to the teens would be a quote that someone, actually a Boys and Girls Club alum said to me, Martin Sensmeyer. He said, you have to stop trying to be and start being. In a world where every single day, it seems like there's a new way to be, a better way to be, a better dress, a better shoe, a better food, superfood, a better way to show up with activism. It's always more, 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 more. None of that will matter if you're not being who you are. And sometimes being who you are is scary. Sometimes the people around you don't want you to be who you are. But if you can truly make it a mission to love who you are, no matter what, if you enjoy eating kale dry and it makes you so happy, you know, be that person, you know? If people tell you that it's not cool to drink so much water, be like, well, my gut's really happy. Just knowing that going forward with whatever comes out of this time, the uncertainty, not knowing if you're gonna be in school, you know, next year, not having a prom, all of the things that you were promised, you know, the thing that got you through the school year, your prom, your graduation, like you're like, I took all these tests and now I don't get a prom. Hugging yourself and being so proud, every single person who's watching this right now, being so proud of yourselves that you made it through one of the hardest years mentally for everybody in your age bracket, that you did it. So really being proud of yourself going forward in 2020, and always remembering that this isn't easy, but you're doing it. And that's something that you're gonna look back on in many, many years, and you're gonna go, you know what? I graduated during quarantine. Because there's a quote that I love, and I came up with it, and I say it all the time. And it's, legends don't fit in. no legend ever fit in. Good or bad, but no legend ever fit in. And I think a lot of times, especially the youth, feels like they have to fit in, that they have to be as good, that they have to look as good, they have to wear the same things. But the reality is you don't really stand out if you fit in. So if you wanna make a dent in the world, be great, but be your version of great. Because if you're your version of great, nobody can ever dispute it. And that's the same thing for your mind. Someone might like to meditate, but you might like to listen to a certain type of music. Neither are wrong. It's just finding your formula. And I cannot wait to see what you all do with the formulas that you are creating for yourselves and for others with the world as we go forward. So thank you for taking the time out to hear from me, because I look up to you all.
Thank you, Damaris and Marlon, and a special thanks to T-Mobile, this year's Emotional Wellness Super Session sponsor. T-Mobile is a national workforce partner who inspires the next generation to think about their next steps towards career success. Their hope is that participants leave their program with the message that regardless of their background or socioeconomic status, a career path is within reach. The partnership is working to enhance virtual opportunities during the pandemic. Okay, are you ready to enter for a chance to win more prizes? Now, get ready to email keystoneclubs@bgca.org. Here's your question. What kind of ambassador is Damaris for Boys and Girls Clubs of America? A, ambassador for fun. B, beauty ambassador. C, ambassador of wellness. Or D, ambassador of positivity. What kind of ambassador is Damaris for Boys and Girls Clubs of America? A, ambassador for fun. B, beauty ambassador. C, ambassador of wellness. Or D, ambassador of positivity. Okay. Email the correct answer to keystoneclubs@bgca.org and you will be entered to win a spectacular prize. Keystoners, how are you all doing? As a senior this year, I am sorry to miss all of my school's annual traditions and prom, but I have enjoyed spending time with my family. I've never been closer to my sisters. I feel really grateful that I got more time with them before I start college. I want you all to remember, if you ever need support, you know you can always count on your club and your fellow Keystoners. I also want to take the time to share this great resource. The Crisis Text Line is free and offers 24/7 support for those in crisis. Text CLUB to 741-741 from anywhere in the U.S. to text with a trained crisis counselor. It's time for the next round of awards. Don't forget to congratulate the nominees in the chat. First, we're going to recognize some clubs that have really taken teen outreach to the next level. The nominees for this year's Teen Outreach Award are Bentonville Teen Center, Boys and Girls Clubs of Benton County, Dream Teens, Ramstein Youth Programs, High Key Keystone Club, and Hartley and Ruth Barker Branch, from Boys and Girls Clubs of Greater Scottsdale, Barker ECC Keystone. And the award for Teen Outreach goes to Ramstein Youth Programs, High Key Keystone Club. Congrats, High Key Keystoners. Next is the award for the Keystone National Project, Think, Feel, Do. The nominees are Grenville Baker Boys and Girls Club, Diverse Unity, Ridgefield Boys and Girls Club, Ridgefield Tigers, Rogers Teen Center Boys and Girls Clubs of Benton County, Unidos Dream. And the Keystone National Project Award goes to Ridgefield Boys and Girls Club, Ridgefield Tigers. Congrats, Tigers. The next award is the Deborah Williams Clark Spirit of Keystone Award, which honors an advisor who has shown a commitment to motivating new advisors to the movement and inspiring them to build a quality leadership experience for teens. The nominees are Hilda Herrera of Boys and Girls Clubs of Los Angeles Harbor, my own advisor, Jeffrey Gelott, Boys and Girls Clubs of Sarasota County, Beethoven Felix of Boys and Girls Clubs of Greater Scottsdale. And the Spirit of Keystone Award goes to the Boys and Girls Clubs of Greater Scottsdale, Beethoven Felix. Congratulations to all of the winners so far today. Now please welcome back Jeffrey.
Keystoners, it's time for a little fun. Grab your phones to email keystoneclubs@bgca.org. The answers to these four questions. Don't forget to include the answers to all four questions. You have to have them all right for a chance to win. So who's ready for some trivia? My peeps in Texas better get this first question right. Which Houston superstar is pursuing their collegiate dreams despite their quick rise to fame? Is it A, Beyonce, B, Megan Thee Stallion, or C, Travis Scott, or D, Hilary Duff? Which Houston superstar is pursuing their collegiate dreams despite their quick rise to fame? A, Beyonce, B, Megan Thee Stallion, C, Travis Scott, D, Hilary Duff. Here's the second question. Which club alum pranked his TikTok followers by breaking his two front teeth while creating a life hack video? I'll give you a hint. It involves a drill and a corn cob. Is it A, Trey Songz, B, Deshaun Watson, C, Matt Bonner, or D, Jason Derulo? Which club alum pranked his TikTok followers by breaking his two front teeth while creating a life hack video? I'll give you a hint. It involves a drill and a corn cob. Is it A, Trey Songz, B, Deshaun Watson, C, Matt Bonner, or D, Jason Derulo? Third question. What is the name of the Instagram Live music battle where musicians compete to decide who has a better catalog? Is it A, Battle Rap Live, B, Versus, C, Instagram Takeover, or D, Who's Next? What is the name of the Instagram Live music battle where musicians compete to decide who has a better catalog? Is it A, Battle Rap Live, B, Versus, C, Instagram Takeover, or D, Who's Next? And the final question. Which celebrity is best known for their phrase, "We the best"? Is it A, DJ Khaled, B, Justin Bieber, C, Chance the Rapper, or D, Kylie Jenner? Which celebrity is best known for their phrase, "We the best"? A, DJ Khaled, B, Justin Bieber, C, Chance the Rapper, or D, Kylie Jenner? Email keystoneclubs@bgca.org. Thanks for playing. Everyone, the winners will be notified via email next week. At this time, we invite you to take a break. If you registered for a breakout session, you will go to your session using the information that was given to you as part of your conference registration at 3:40 p.m. Eastern Time. After the Passport to Manhood and the Smart Girl session, you'll meet us back here in this online conference room. If you didn't get to register for the breakout sessions, we'll see you back here at 4:15 p.m. Eastern Time. Be sure to come back because you don't want to miss what's next. I promise.
Welcome back, everyone. I hope you all enjoyed your session as much as I did. Thanks again to Dre Brown and Tony Weaver for taking the time to talk to us. And thank you to Dove, this year's Smart Girls Session sponsor. Next, we will be presenting the last two Keystone Awards. So be ready to congratulate the winners.
In our eyes, all of our advisors do award-winning jobs, but this person stands out. The nominees for Advisor of the Year are Maria Blue, MWR Youth Center, Kings Bay Keystone Club, Ryan Flynn, USAG, Rhineland Bombholder, Keystone Club, Jeff Goncalves, Boys and Girls Club, Ridgefield Tigers. And the award for the Advisor of the Year goes to Jeff Goncalves, Ridgefield Boys and Girls Club, Ridgefield Tigers. Congratulations, Jeff. Let me see my Northeast clubs holla in the chat. The next award is the one we've all been waiting for. The nominees for Keystone Club of the Year are Grenville Baker Boys and Girls Club, Diverse Unity Keystone Club, USAG Ryland Falls CYS Services Rocket Keystone Club, Ridgefield Boys and Girls Club, Ridgefield Tigers. And the award for the Keystone Club of the Year goes to Grenville Baker Boys and Girls Club, Diverse Unity Club. Just like Diverse Unity, as Keystoners, we already know that we can make a difference in our communities. Now, I'd like to introduce our closing speaker, a woman who knows how to make a difference. In addition to being an advocate for those in need, she is the CEO of her own company. She helps businesses develop social impact strategies. She is also the director of social responsibility for Be Good, the philanthropic umbrella of Parkwood Entertainment, the company founded by Beyonce Knowles Carter. She has led projects that include relief efforts after Hurricane Harvey and campaigns to provide safer water to Flint, Michigan, in Africa. She has also coordinated scholarship programs and has been delighted to share annually at Howard University in the Faith and Justice Speakers Series. Please welcome Ivy McGregor.
Thank you so much, Fatima. What an incredible introduction. Hey, I'm so happy to be with you all to have this opportunity to hang out with the Boys and Girls Club of America on this Friday afternoon. There's no other place that I would be than right here and right now. So I have this amazing opportunity to share space with each of you this afternoon. And so before we get into what our conversation. Let me share a bit about myself. My name is Ivy McGregor. I grew up in Minneapolis, Minnesota, and that's where I was first introduced to the Boys and Girls Club of America. I am the youngest of five children. I have four other siblings, two older brothers and two older sisters. Yes, I'm the baby of the bunch. I bet we have some baby children on this Zoom today as well. Nonetheless, very, very meager beginnings. My mother and father were married and into their marriage. Unfortunately, they divorced. And so my mother was left to raise five children alone. And I bet there are probably some young people on this Zoom who also came from a single parent family. And we survived. I'm proof positive that good things still happen. And so I grew up in Minneapolis, Minnesota. It was extremely, extremely cold there, which is why I moved to Texas years later and now live in New York City. But we had very challenging times when I was growing up. And so the Boys and Girls Club was very, very, very instrumental in my upbringing, very instrumental to my mother having a safe place where her children could go and where my siblings and I were able to go and hang out. So now fast forward all of these years later and to get to have an opportunity to share space with each of you is very, very, very special. So I want to say thank you to the coordinators that put this together for us to have this opportunity to talk. So who is Ivy McGregor? Many of you know that I get the extreme honor and privilege to work for Beyonce Knowles Carter. I'm a part of her management team, executive management team, and oversee all of her philanthropic efforts. Many of you are aware of Be Good, which is her philanthropy. And I get to create programs and partnerships all over the country that help people where they are, that help encourage people, that help inspire people. And you may know that we had the wonderful opportunity to develop a program where young people from the Boys and Girls Club of America were selected all over the country to be participants in the first ever scholarship program that we had, that we put together for On the Run 2 scholars, where young people were selected to receive $100,000 scholarships. So I had the honor of working with the Boys and Girls Club to develop this program. And the Boys and Girls Club was amazing about selecting who we would work with, who were the young people that would get to receive these scholarships. I'm sharing that because having that opportunity reminded me and brought me back to being a young girl in Minneapolis, Minnesota, that was able to participate in Boys and Girls Club. And so I'm sharing with you today as a professional woman that has climbed up through the ranks in my career to try to better myself, to create space in the world that would empower other people, that even though you have tough beginnings, even though you have beginnings that may be like mine, where you grew up in a single parent home, I share with people, we grew up in what was then called the projects, where my mother had subsidized housing. And some of you may be aware of that or may even live in those conditions. But I share that to say, to encourage someone, that good things come from sometimes what feels like challenging situations. So be encouraged. And make sure that you connect with other adults that really see something special in you. So my beginnings, again, Minneapolis, Minnesota was where we began. That was where my education started. And I always had a desire in me to do something great in life. I didn't know what that looked like. I didn't know that one day I'd get the honor of working for Beyonce. I didn't know that, but I knew that education was where it started. So for each of you, we're living in such a time right now where young people are leading this whole change generation that's happening. And each of you have an opportunity to be a part of that change. We saw what recently happened in my hometown of Minneapolis, Minnesota. It's where this whole movement began of social justice around George Floyd. And it's been inspiring to see that people all over the world, you didn't have to be black, you didn't have to be white to look at that video and feel something. All you had to be was human. And so human people have come together all over the world to bring about a change. And I did a little research and I understand that the people leading the change are young people, like many of you that are on this call today. You are leading this change. And so I want to talk to you just about how you continue in this whole space of change and how you make sure that you're not only witnessing what other people are doing, but you yourself are a part of that change. First, it begins with education. I didn't like every single class that I went to. I didn't like every single facilitator, every single instructor, but I knew in order to make a difference in the world, in order to get to a place where I could help my mother, where I could be something that could make a difference in the world, it started with education. So I want to encourage you. I know that you're living in different times right now where many of you were into your school pursuits were interrupted by this thing called COVID. But I want you to know that COVID has come and it's pulled out innovation. It's pulled out collaboration. It's pulled out partnerships and strategies that many people didn't even know that existed within them. And that's being led by young people like each and every one of you. So the first key point that I want you to jot down is the power of your education. Now, I talked about how COVID has interrupted that. And so many of you have had to do class online. You've had to participate in more Zoom and technology conference calls than you probably like. But it's caused you to learn in a whole different way. And so education is not just one way. It's not just inside of a classroom and an instructor teaching you. Education is what you're teaching yourself. So I want to challenge you. What books are you reading? What are you studying in your free time? What movies have you seen that really sparked excitement in you to do a little digging and researching of other things, other ideas? So the first point of change starts with education. The second point to change and unity is innovation. Looking at new ways to understand different cultures, to understand different ideas, it starts with innovation. How can you cross lines and understand a different culture and understand people that don't live where you live? I'll tell you a story. I grew up and I went my first year of high school, I went to a public school and then I transferred to a private school. I didn't know any other young people at this school and there were no kids that looked like me. I was the only Black female in my graduating class. And so I had to go and make friends with other people. And there was a young man, Tom Bird, never forget Tom. Tom befriended me day one that I entered this high school. I didn't know anybody and we remained friends throughout throughout my high school career. But Tom was my friend and he didn't live where I lived. And he didn't have the challenges that my mother had raising five children alone, but Tom was my friend. And so I was able to innovate even mentally in terms of who can I befriend and what does friendship look like? And so the first point we talk about education, and education is not just what you're taught, but education is how you are teaching yourself. And then the second point is innovation. How are you innovating your ideas? What is it that you want to do to help bring about a change in the world? And while we've been sheltered in place and now we're learning social distancing, you know what those things are doing? Those are really pushing us to really understand what we can do with constraints, with restrictions. We still have the ability, even though you had to take classes online, you were still able to receive your education. So the 2 points so far, is education is critical, but it's not just in its classical sense. And innovation is critical. I want you to, for everyone that's a part of this particular, this Zoom today, I hear that there are over 600 people on. And I want you to think about one thing that you'd like to change. Young people are really engaged with environment. Like I said, there are many young people that are protesting and a part of all of the rallies that are going on. What is one thing that you'd like to change? Write it down. And when you've considered that one thing, I want you to educate yourself. So do some research. Find what others have done related to what you want to do. And then find the gap. Find out what no one has done related to that thing that you want to do. You want to educate yourself. And when you find the gap, you want to get real creative and think, what can I innovate? What can I create? What is the solution that I can come up with? And the third point that I want to talk to you about is partnership and collaboration. We have seen where young people I saw a young girl that was 8 years old, I think it was right in Houston, Texas, that came up with this idea of a youth rally. And so she got all of the young people in her community and she created a rally and they marched to City Hall because she said that many people that were protesting, that were sharing from an adult perspective. And I share that to say that there are things that you can do and you can discover what hasn't been done by educating yourself and coming up with a creative idea. But thirdly, partnership. It's real important that each of you who are already connected to a Boys and Girls Club of America and you have your coordinators that you work with, but there might be a young person that may not live in your community like Tom, that may not have the struggles and issues that you do, But nonetheless, this is a person that you could partner with. And so I challenge you to think outside what's comfortable, think outside the norm, and think possibly if we connect, we might be able to have a greater impact. So our 3 points, education, innovation, and partnership and collaboration. Education, innovation, and collaboration are key. Each of you are seeing what's happening in our world. Each of you are living through it. I was sharing with the group earlier today that COVID has leveled the playing field. What a person on one side of town is dealing with is the very same thing that a person on your side of town is dealing with. And so I've been tasked to remind you and to encourage you that you're the change. And you're not the change for tomorrow. No, you're not the change for next year. No, you're the change for right now. And you have exactly what it takes. You have the unique ability to create a change in your community, starting in your home, starting with your friends. You have the opportunity to dismantle things that disconnect us. And you have the opportunity to connect us and to collaborate and to unite. And so I want you to be encouraged. I want you to go into this summer month excited that you have life and that you have opportunity to continue to creating change. Change starts with education and then how you're able to create innovation and then to look at collaboration. My life is an example of a young kid that actually was a participant in Boys and Girls Club and had a huge dream that one day, and it just started like this, one day I want to make things better for my mom, but it grew from there. And many of you that are a part of this call today, maybe a kid like me that just had a big dream. I just want to make things better for my family. And I want you to know that I believe in you, that you absolutely have what it takes to make a difference, and you will stay connected to a program and organization that is invested in your education, that's invested in your development, that's invested in your community. So you're right in line with an incredible group that can help see you through to change. Lastly, I want to say to you, the power of family. It's so, so, so important. Now that people are social distancing and it's teaching us to stay apart from one another, but being connected to your foundation of family is so critically important. And I'll say this, family looks different for everybody. And whatever your family looks like, I want to encourage you to stay connected. That is your foundation. And on your toughest days, those people are going to be with you. So I hope that something that's been said today has inspired you to really realize that you are the community that's not creating change tomorrow, but you are creating change today. Keep going. Keep making your family proud. Keep making your clubs proud. Keep making your club directors proud. And I want to say from one young lady in New York City that I'm super proud of each and every one of you. And I'm going to follow up with the Boys and Girls Club and maybe 6 months, maybe sooner, and check on each and every one of you and see how you're doing. Continue to go forward. Keep the smile on your face. Keep the joy in your heart. And know that things are going to get better. And the way that I know that they're going to get better is it starting with each and every one of you. God bless you. God bless America. And continue to make a great change. Thank you.
Thank you so much, Ivy. We are so grateful for your inspiring words. Okay, Keystoners, we want to hear from you and what you want in terms of virtual programming, but also what you want to talk about. So in a moment, a polling feature is going to come up with a series of questions for you. Please take the time to answer the polling question. And because we love giving away prizes, if you take a screenshot of you taking the poll and email keystoneclubs@bgca.org, you will be entered to win another prize. Wow, I can't believe how time has flown. We'll be wrapping up our virtual conference soon. Before we go, there's a few more steering committee videos we would like you to see.
Friends, now more than ever, we need to come together as future leaders to elevate our voices and make a positive, meaningful change in our world.
We must rise to the occasion and push for social, political, and economic transformation. We need a revolution.
It is time we have open conversations about topics important to us today, like emotional wellness, climate change, community violence, addiction, voting rights, and addressing anti-racism and social justice. Our revolution can happen with some TLC from all of us. TLC stands for thinking, learning, and creating change.
The first step is T, which stands for thinking. What's an issue in your community that needs to be addressed? What topics are coming up around the globe that interest or concern you? What are you passionate about? And what about your rights as a teen?
The second step is L, which stands for learning. Educate yourself. Find credible sources to learn details about the issues or topics that you're passionate about. Collaborate with your Boys and Girls Club to find allies in your community who will help you to understand the issues and what may be happening to create positive change.
The last step is C, which stands for create change. You are a leader. When you think about what's important to you and learn about the facts about why it's important, you are then prepared to take strategic action to take the steps to create change.
It is our social responsibility to stand up, advocate, be civically engaged, and take action through the TLC steps, and let our voices be heard.
Keystone members and guests, we invite you to be seen.
We invite you to be heard.
And we invite all of you to be united.
As tomorrow's leaders, let's elevate our voices and unite to push for change. Here's what you can do. Check out the Keystone Club Planner with tons of resources to help with your Keystone Club and help you start your TLC process about issues you care about. Another way is by checking out our new national project resource that will be available on September 1st at the start of the new Keystone Charter. The National Project Guide will be focused on climate change. So start thinking about a project for your club. You can also connect with your Keystone Club advisor about what issues are important to you and how you might learn more about the topic so you can start your work in creating change. Make sure to explore myfuture.net and see what ways you can put change into action. Most importantly, if you're 18, make sure to register to vote. Above all, friends, join your local Boys and Girls Club and be a part of our movement.
We want to know what each of you declare. Share your pictures and videos with the hashtag WeTheYouth2020.
I declare to be understood.
I declare to be limitless.
I declare to be courageous.
I declare to be a visionary.
I declare to be unique.
I declare to be dynamic.
I declare to be creative.
I declare to be unstoppable.
I declare to be inspirational.
And I declare to be fearless.
I have really enjoyed being a part of this year's conference, even if I didn't get to see any part of DC. Before we go, I have a few announcements I'd like to share before I introduce our last act of the virtual National Keystone Conference. Okay, listen up, because there are some really cool things coming up for you to elevate your powerful voices and take action. First up, on August 5th at 2 p.m. Eastern, clubs across the country are partnering to host a virtual town hall right here on My Future. This event will focus on empowerment and supporting teens in social change and racial justice. It's going to be led by teens and we want you to attend, so mark your calendars. You can also join us for the Whatever It Takes to Speak Your Mind event on Thursday, August 6th at 4 p.m. Eastern on myfuture.net. Together, BGCA, Wide Open School, and Poetry in America invite you to speak your mind about what's going on with you through spoken word, poetry, or rap. You will learn about lyricism and rhyme through activities and resources and will have a chance to win prizes. Finally, if you are looking to get a jump start in advocating for change, head over to the program page on myfuture.net and look at the new Keystone badge under Teens. You'll find a series of activities to support the TLC progress, helping you to think, learn, and create change. And be sure to check out the Whatever It Takes to Make Positive Change series, which was designed to encourage teens to create a business that can solve a problem in your community. If you have an interest in starting your own business and want a chance to win $750, visit myfuture.net. Finally, it wouldn't be Keystone without Roll Call, so be sure to check out how you can virtually submit your Keystone Roll Call on myfuture.net. I'd like to introduce you to the last act of our virtual National Keystone Conference, but this club alum needs no introduction, so I'm going to turn it over to him.
White churches, black churches, different people, same hearses. It's kind of hard to fight with each other, laying down in the ground, six under. At every show, I see my people, they ain't the same, but they're all equal. One love, one God, one family. You're missing every color if you're only seeing black and white. Tell me how you're gonna change your mind if your heart's unmovable. We ain't that different from each other, from one to another. I look around and see worldwide beautiful. Thank God, thank God, thank God, thank God, thank God, thank God. Oh, thank God, thank God, thank God, thank God, thank God, thank God. Coast to coast, city to city, reach out your hands if you're with me. Still got some work, but we still got a dream. Every shade, every heart come together and sing. Oh, thank God, thank God, thank God, thank God, thank God, thank God. You're missing every color. Seeing black and white, tell me how you gonna change your mind if your heart's unmovable. We ain't that different from each other, from one to another. I look around and see worldwide beautiful. One love, one God, one family, one family. Change your mind if your heart's unmovable. We ain't that different from each other, from one to another. I look around and see worldwide beautiful. Look around and see worldwide beautiful. So beautiful. Look around and see worldwide.
Thank you, Kane Brown. I think the first virtual Keystone Conference went pretty well. I hope you'll all get to attend in person next year, though. My friends, Taylor and Marlon might be able to share a little more about the location for 2021.
Wait, we're not done yet. Don't log off. We still have a few surprises.
Before we go, we would like to thank our sponsors, Aaron's, Dove, and T-Mobile for their generous support for the first ever virtual National Keystone Conference.
I hope you guys are all listening to what we're about to share with you.
Do you want to know where we're hopefully going next year in 2021?
Sunglasses and sunblock ready. Keystone is headed to
Anaheim, California!
Thanks, Taylor and Marlon. Bring on the California sun. Show some love in the chat box, California and PAC Keystoners. We can't wait to visit you. Until then, don't be afraid to speak up, use your voice. Remember that we, the youth, declare to be heard, seen, and united. On behalf of the 2020 Steering Committee, I want to thank everyone for attending and everyone who helped put this presentation together. We appreciate you.